Students, I will complete one more problem. So the problem is find a square minus 5a plus 6i if a equal to 201, 213, 1 minus 1, 0. So it is a part of 3 by 3. So the answer is like this. Find a square minus 5a plus 6i equal to. So what is a square? A square is nothing but a into a. A into a. So a is 201, 213, 1 minus 1, 0. Into that itself, 201, 213, 1 minus 1, 0. 5a minus 5 into a, a is again same matrix, 201, 213, 1 minus 1, 0, plus 6i. So what is i? I is of same order. I is an identity matrix of same order, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Now just simplification, multiply and simplify. So you know already matrix multiplication, first row with first column. So I will do directly equal to 2 into 2 4, 0 plus into 2 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1, 4 plus 1 is 5, see 2 into 2 is 4. First row into first column, 2 into 2 is 4, 0 into 2 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1, so 4 plus 1 is 5. Next one, 2 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1, 2 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Last one, 2 into 1 is 2, 0 into 3 is 0, 1 into 0 is 0, so 2 into 1 is 2. So first row is completed. Next, 2 into 2 is 4, 1 into 2 is 2, 3 into 1 is 3. So 4 plus 2, 6 plus 3, 9. 2 into 2 is 4, 1 into 2 is 2, 4 plus 2, 6 plus 3, 9. Next one, 2 into 0 is 0, 1 into 1 is 1, 3 into minus 1 is minus 3, minus 3 plus 1, so minus 2. Next, last one, 2 into 1 is 2, 1 into 3 is 3, 2 plus 3 is 5, this is 0, this is 5. Last, 1 into 2 is 2, minus 1 into 2 is minus 2, 2 and minus 2 cancels, 0 into 1 is 0. Next one, 1 into 0 is 0, minus 1 into 1, minus 1, 0 into minus 1 is 0, so minus 1. Last one, 1 into 1 is 1, minus 1 into 3, minus 3, 0 into 0, 0. So minus 3 plus 1, so minus 2. Yes, calculation, you have to be careful, rest as simple. Minus 5 into all the elements, 10, 0, 5. 10, 5, 15, next, 5, minus 5, 0, plus 6 into all those, 6 into, I mean, like this, 6, 0, 0, 6, 0, 6, 0, 0, 0, 6, add and simplify, that's all. So this is plus 5 plus 6, 11, 11 minus 10, 1. Next, minus 1, 0, 0, so minus 1. Next, 2, minus 5, minus 3. Next one, 9, minus 10, minus 1, plus 0, so minus 1. Next, minus 2, minus 5, minus 7. Minus 7, plus 6, plus 1. Next, 5, minus 15, minus 10. 0, minus 5 is minus 5. 0, minus 5, so minus 5. Next, minus 1, minus minus, it will be plus, minus 1 plus 5. So minus 1 plus 5 means 4 plus 0, 4. Last one, minus 2, minus 0, minus 2 only plus 6, plus 4. Next, simplify the calculation, you have to check. I mean, 5 minus 10, 5, 10, minus 5 plus 6, 1, I think, correct. Minus 1, 0. 0, minus 1, correct. 2, minus 5, minus 3, correct. 9, minus 10, minus 1, other one is 0. Minus 2, minus 5, minus 7, plus 6. Minus 2 here, this one. 9, minus 2, okay. Minus 2, minus 5, minus 7, plus 6, minus 1. Minus 2, minus 7, minus 7, plus 6, minus 1. Next, 5, minus 15. 5 minus 15, minus 10. Next. Minus 5, 0 minus 5, minus 5. Minus 1 plus 5, 4. Last one. Minus 2, this is 0 only. Minus 2 plus 6, 4. Next one, next topic. Transpose. Next topic. Transpose. Transpose of a matrix. What is transpose of a matrix? If A is a matrix of m cross n order, then its transpose will be of order n cross m. If A is an order m cross n, then its transpose denoted by, like this also, transpose of A denoted as A dash or AT, like this also. So this is nothing but transpose of A. Transpose of A equal to A dash equal to AT. It is of order N cross M. So if it is having M rows and N columns, then when you transpose it, it will become N rows and M columns. So what will happen? Actually happen is, so interchange of rows and columns takes place. Rows will become columns, columns will become rows. I will explain it with examples. So first example, let A equal to say 2, 3, simple one will consider 4, 5. So what is A transpose? A transpose or A dash or like this also, one and the same, all are the same. Equal to, what will happen? This is the first rule. 2, 3 is the first rule. It will become first column. So 2, 3. First row will become first column. Like this. Same way, second row will become second column. This is how transpose takes place. Of course, here A is 2 cross 2 order. Transpose also 2 cross 2 order. Transpose also 2 cross 2 order. I will explain some more, one more example. So if A equal to, say, A or B, B equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is the order of this matrix? This has three rows, two columns. One row, second row, third row. Three rows, two columns. So how its transpose will be? Then V transpose equal to, observe. So first row will become first column. First row becomes first column. So 1, 2 here. Second row will become second column like this. Last 5, 6. That is third row will become third column. What is the order of this? Its order is first row, second row. So how many columns? 3 columns. Its order is 2×3. Easy to remember. First row will become first column. Second row will become second column. Third row will become third column. So if it is 3×2 order, then the transpose of that will be 2×3 order. There are some properties of transposes. For example, A equal to 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the transpose? A dash 2, 4, 3, 5. Now what is A dash? Dash. It's a transpose. What it is? According to definition, transpose this further. A is this much, 2, 3, 4, 5. A dash is this much. What is A dash whole dash? A dash whole dash. Equal to, transpose this. So this first row will become first column. Next, 3, 5. Second row will become second column. So what is this? This you observe is nothing but A only. 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. So I can say that A dash whole dash, transpose of transpose will give you the original matrix. Transpose of the transpose will give you the original matrix, which is A. A dash O dash equal to A. So some of the properties, this is one of the property. So this is property 1. Properties. So this is one property, A dash O dash equal to A. Second one, later on we will give some examples and verify. A plus B whole dash equal to A dash plus B dash. Third one, A minus B whole dash, A minus B whole dash equal to A dash minus B dash. Fourth one, KA whole dash, the K is a scalar, K is a constant, a scalar, equal to K into A dash. Then fifth one, AB whole dash equal to B dash A dash. AB whole dash equal to B dash A dash. So these are some of the properties of transpose. Next, some problems. Let us solve some problems. So before that, I will give some more theorems actually. Theorem, one theorem. Problems I will do later. So theorems. Theorems. theorem. The theorem says that if A is a square matrix with real number entries, if A is a square matrix with the real number entries, then A plus A dash is symmetric. And A minus A dash is skew symmetric. Now before proving this theorem, we try to understand what is a symmetric matrix, what is a skew symmetric matrix. So what is a symmetric matrix? Symmetric matrix, what is that? Matrix is said to be symmetric if A dash is equal to E. I just gave briefly, later on I will give some more examples. For theorem purpose, I will give briefly. So if A dash is equal to E, a square matrix is said to be symmetric if A transpose itself is itself, that is symmetric. What about skew symmetric? Skew symmetric means A dash equal to minus A. This much you remember now. To prove this theorem, or we require proving the theorem. So, what is a symmetric matrix? Basically, a matrix is said to be symmetric if its transpose is itself. If A dash equal to A, then it is symmetric. What is skew symmetric? A square matrix is said to be skew symmetric if A transpose A dash equal to minus A. A dash equal to minus A. So this is symmetric. A dash equal to minus A means skew symmetric. I will give in the next class different examples how to do it, all those things. But let us prove this theorem. For theorem purpose, this is enough. A dash equal to A dash equal to minus A. Okay. Next. So let us calculate one by one. So answer us to proof. What is the proof of this theorem? Proof. A plus A dash is symmetric. So what is A plus A dash whole dash? Let us check it. Because when you say symmetric, it is symmetric if A dash equal to A. So I will consider A plus A dash whole dash. By definition, I have given some properties. So A plus B whole dash. What is that property? A plus B whole dash. I have given as A dash plus B dash. This is given. So we will prove it. It is given our property. So we will use it now. So according to this, this is equal to A dash plus A dash whole dash. But what is this is equal to A dash plus A dash whole dash. Transpose and transpose already given. First property. It is equal to A. Now A plus A dash whole dash equal to A dash plus A. It is nothing but A plus A dash because matrix addition is commutative. Matrix addition is commutative. So A plus A dash here, whole dash equal to A dash plus A. Or I can write, okay, A plus A dash. None the same now because it is commutative. A dash plus A is same as A plus A dash. So what we got is A plus A dash whole dash equal to A plus A dash. Therefore, A plus A dash is symmetric. It is symmetric. So, symmetric.
ruled. Second part, what is the second part? A minus A dash is skew symmetric. A minus A dash. We calculate again. A minus A dash whole dash. By definition, or using the property, this is nothing but A dash minus A dash whole dash. Like here only, property A minus B whole dash. Just you have seen now, here only. A dash minus B dash. A minus B whole dash is A dash minus A dash. And apply that here. A minus A dash whole dash is A dash minus A dash whole dash. But this is equal to A dash minus A dash whole dash, which is A. This is equal to, observe here, this is equal to minus of A minus A dash. Correct? Minus of A minus A dash. Observe. So what is here? A minus A dash whole dash equal to minus of A minus A dash. That is, you have proved like this. A dash equal to minus A. A dash equal to minus A dash here whole dash equal to minus of A minus A dash. That is what is done. So A minus A dash whole dash equal to minus of A minus A dash. You have proved skew symmetric. Therefore, I can say that A minus A dash is skew symmetric. Is skew symmetric. So symmetric means you prove that A dash equal to A. Skew symmetric means you have to prove that A dash equal to minus A. Just properties we have learned, it proved two things. A plus A dash we got whole dash equal to A plus A dash. Same thing. So it is symmetric. Here A minus A dash whole dash equal to minus of one. That's what I told. Skew symmetric. A dash equal to minus A. This is one theorem. Next theorem. Any square matrix A can be minutely expressed. As the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. Number a symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. Skew symmetric matrix. Now write say A as C, some B plus C, where B equal to 1 by 2 into A plus A dash, C equal to 1 by 2 into A minus A dash. Now observe. This is what? A plus A dash is symmetric. What about A minus A dash? This is skew symmetric. You already see. Just proven earlier. So what you have done? I can write A equal to B plus C, where B equal to half a plus a dash and c equal to half a minus a dash. Because what is b plus c? Now b plus c equal to what is b plus c? B plus c is half into a plus a dash plus half into a minus a dash. So here observe this a dash cancels. Half a dash minus half a dash. Half a plus half a. This is nothing but. So I can write a equal to b plus c. I can write a equal to b plus c, where b equal to half into a plus a dash, which is symmetric, and c equal to half into a minus a dash, which is skew symmetric. So this is unique. There is no other element. No other element. This also unique. So any square matrix can be expressed uniquely as the sum of a skew symmetric matrix and a skew symmetric matrix. We will have some more things in the next class, but whatever I have done, go through it. Thank you.